Self and peer assessments in Blackboard Learn. After following the steps in this video, you will be able to access a self and peer assessment in your course to submit an assignment, access a self and peer assessment to grade submissions, and view the grades and feedback from peers. Right now, I'm logged into a course as a student and I'm about to complete a self and peer assessment. In this particular course, assignments are directly on the menu, but you might need to look around or ask your instructor exactly where the assessment is posted in the course. So at the top of my page here, you'll see self and peer graded assignment. I could view the submission dates, so that's when I need to respond to this assignment, and I can also view the evaluation dates, so that's when I need to go in and grade my own work and or the work of my peers. So to begin, I'll click on View Complete Assessment. And in this particular assessment, there's only one question, and I can see it right here. But in order to respond to this question, I have to click on the title of it. The question appears again at the top of the page, and I can respond just below that in the response text box. If you need to use some of the options that aren't appearing right now in the text editor, click on the double set of arrows at the top right corner of the editor and you should have a lot more options. So you can type your response right here in the text box, or you can browse your computer for a file attachment. It's up to you. In this example, I'm just going to type a response. And I'll click Submit. Now, besides status, it says that this question is completed. To leave this page, I can scroll to the bottom and click OK. And I won't need to return to this area until it's the evaluation period. I've logged back into the course and it's now the evaluation period, so I'm going to click on the View Complete Assessment link so that I can grade my own work and the work of two others. So as you scroll down on the page, you'll see that your own name, if you were allowed to grade yourself, will appear at the top. And if this was set to anonymous, the other people you're grading will just show up as user 1, user 2, and so forth. To begin grading, you click on a name, and you'll get to the question. If they've submitted any text directly into the text box, it would appear here. In this case, they've just included an attachment, so it's a hyperlink that I could click on. And below their submission, there's the criteria that the instructor has entered. To open any attachments, you just double-click on it and it'll open on your computer. And when you're ready to grade, you can type your feedback in the feedback box. And you'll enter the points that you'll be giving them for this question. So in this case, I'll give them a 2 out of 2. And then you can just click Save and Submit. So now I can access other submissions that I should grade if there's more. In my case, I have 3 total. This one in the middle I've just graded, so it's labeled as completed. And the points that I've given them have appeared there as well. I'll just move on to another user. In this case, it tells me that the user did not submit a response for this question, therefore points cannot be allocated. They'll automatically receive a 0, so I'll just click Submit. And finally, in this case, I have to grade my own, so I'll click on my name. And I'm not so proud of my own response there, so I might just give myself a 1. And finally click Save and Submit. Up to the evaluation end date, you can edit how you've graded your peers or your own paper. So as long as this evaluation end date has not passed, you can go back in and click on a student's name or user 1 if that's what's appearing. And you can change the feedback you've provided as well as the grade you've given that student. If you make any changes, just be sure to click Save and Submit. When you'd like to review your feedback and the grades you've received for this self and peer assessment, there are 2 places you can look for that. One is directly where the assignment was posted, if it's still available to you. and you'd click on the same View Complete Assessment link. So again, if that area was still available to you, you can see your submission. You can no longer edit that. But below, you can see how you did on the assessment and the specific feedback that was given to you by your peers. Another place to check is in My Grades, and that's usually directly on the course menu. And you'll locate the title of the assessment. So here it is. And if you click on the title of the assessment, you'll be able to take a look at the points you received and the feedback, but in a different view.